the focus of the class is computational creativity. And what that means is it's all about this idea of how can we make computers be creative? Everybody made a cookie. And the way that cookie was produced was all of those students made a computer algorithm that would produce the recipe that they would then go on and bake.
So we have a pretty creative one. Ours includes raisins, apricots, zucchini, and a Middle Eastern spice blend called baharat.
Dark chocolate, white chocolate, caramel chips, marshmallow, and pretzels.
Chocolate-based cookies with peppermint patties chopped up in them and orange and lemon zested in it, and maple syrup drizzled on that was then baked in.
Our algorithm uses a system that a human mind would kind of use.
It's like the way a chef or a person would come up with a cookie. They'd start with the dough and they'd add an ingredient and they'd be like, okay, how can I make this cookie better by adding another ingredient?
But our system's actually a little smarter than a human mind because we know on our preferences what we think would pair well together, but the system actually encapsulates what all people would want based on the recipes where the ingredients co-occur.
We use Python as our language, and we scraped, like King Arthur Flour has a website full of cookie recipes, and pulled off all the ingredient names and stripped down that so we just had the ingredient and no values, and put that into this big like database. And so we were able to give each ingredient a fitness function, but it's still got the ability to mutate, like add an ingredient or remove an ingredient.
So I really like this project just because it's really different from anything I've ever done in the computer science department. I also really like baking, and it's really fun to kind of mix computer science, which is, you know, you think of as really programmatic and rule-based, to something that's creative and can generate novel things.
Computer science can be used for good, and this is just one way.